Hello guys, it's Zeep Shah over here, and today I'm going to show you how to create this 3D text without using inbuilt function of 3D in Photoshop. Also, if you want to learn how to create such cool things using Photoshop, then hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. So without wasting any time, let's get started. So the first step over here is we need to create a new document. So for that, go to File and then select Option New. After that, you can set the width and height accordingly, or else you can set it as follows. And then click on OK. After that, we need to find the center point of this document over here. So for that, bring on the rulers by pressing Ctrl plus R, and then drag from the horizontal ruler to the middle of the vertical document. After that, drag the vertical ruler to the middle of the horizontal document. Now we have the middle point of the document. After that, we need to type in the text. So for that, select horizontal type tool and then select any font of your choice. Now if you want to select the font I'm using, the download link for the font is in the description below. Also, if you don't know how to install font in Photoshop, the link for that is in the description as well. After that, set any appropriate size for the font. And then select foreground color as any color which you like to give to the text. I'm selecting any random color right now. And then click on OK. After that, click on the document and then type in your text. After that, click on the stick icon to place it. Now select Move tool, and then using Move tool, place it at the center of the document. Now once we have placed the text at the center of the document, after that press Ctrl and click on the background layer over here, which will give you the selection of the background layer as well as keep the selection of the text layer. After that, right click over there in the layer and then select option Convert to Smart Object. Now as you can see, we have converted it into a smart object. Now if you want to edit anything inside of the text, then all you need to do is click on the smart object icon over here and a new layer will be opened with that of the smart object, and then click on OK. So now as you can see, we have two documents, the one document in which we will be editing and the other document which contains the smart object. Now if we change or do something in the smart object document, then it will be reflected in the original document as well. Let me show you what I'm telling you by deleting this white background over here. Now make the white background layer active by clicking on it and then press the delete key of your keyboard to delete that background layer. So as you can see, we have removed the white background from the smart object document. After that, press Ctrl plus S to save this smart object document. So now once the smart object document has been saved, after that go to original document. So as you can see, the white background has been removed from the original document as well. So now we need to follow a set of steps in order to create a 3D depth. So for that, the first step is to create a duplicate of the current smart object layer by pressing Ctrl plus J. Now bring the duplicate smart object layer below the original smart object layer. After that, press Ctrl plus T. After that, we need to reduce the height and the width of the duplicate smart object layer by 0.1%. So let's put in the value for the width as 99.9%. And do the same thing for height as well. And then click on the stick icon to place it. So now we have to repeat these 3 steps 75 times in order to get a perfect 3D depth. Sounds hectic, right? No worries, we will let Photoshop do these 3 steps for us, and we will just click on a button to repeat those 3 steps. Now in order to do that, let me just delete this duplicate smart object layer by pressing the delete key of my keyboard. After that, go to Window and then select option Actions. After that, click on Create New Action icon. And then you can give any name of your choice. I'm giving it as 3D. And then click on record. After that, repeat the 3 steps which I told you earlier. Press Ctrl plus J to create a duplicate. Bring that duplicate layer at the bottom. And then press Ctrl plus T. And then scale it by 0.1%. After that, click on the stick icon to place it. So as you can see, it has created a recording of the 3 steps which we have just performed. Now in order to let Photoshop perform the 3 steps for us, all you need to do is make the 3D action layer active by clicking on it. And then all you need to do is click on the play button and the Photoshop will perform the 3 steps for us. So now as you can see, Photoshop has performed the 3 steps for us. Now in order to perform it again, all you need to do is again click on the play button. So like this, we have performed the steps 75 times by clicking on the play button. It was simple performing those steps for the 75 times, wasn't it? Now once you have performed those steps for the 75 times, then make the second top layer active by clicking on it. And then go at the bottom. And then press shift and click on the last object layer, which will give you the selection of the two layers as well as all the layers in between. After that, press Ctrl plus G to merge all the layers into a single group. Let's rename this group as 3D depth. Now expand the group by clicking on the arrow icon and then make the top layer inside of the group active. After that, right click on the layer and then select option blending options. After that, click on bevel and emboss option and then set the bevel and emboss accordingly. Style as inner bevel, technique as smooth, depth to 100%, direction as up, size to 10 pixels. After that, soften to 0 pixel, angle to 90 degree, altitude to 40 degree, and then set the blend mode of the highlight mode as multiply. Change the color of the highlight mode to black. Set its opacity to 30%. Set the blend mode of the shadow mode to multiply, color as black, and set its opacity to 50%. And then click on OK. Now we need to apply this layer style to all of the layers inside of the group, so for that right click on the layer and then select option copy layer style. After that, make the layer below it active by clicking on it and then go at the bottom and then press shift and make the last layer active. After that, right click over there and then select option paste layer style. So as you can see, we have applied the layer style to all of the layers, and after applying the layer style, we have got our 3D depth for the text. Now if you want to decrease the depth of the 3D text, then all you need to do is hide the layers at the bottom of the group by clicking on the eye icon. So as you can see, as we hide the layers, it reduces the depth of the text. Now again unhiding it. So now after that, minimize the group and make the top layer active by clicking on it. And then right click on the layer and then select option blending options. After that, click on bevel and emboss. And then set the following: style as inner bevel, technique as smooth, depth as 100%, direction as up, size to 3 pixels, soften to 1 pixel. After that, click on this use global light option and then set the angle as 100 degree and altitude as 30 degree. Set the blend mode of the highlight mode as normal and color as white and set its opacity to 60%. After that, set the blend mode of the shadow mode to normal, change its color to white, and then change its opacity to 40%. After that, click on inner shadow option, and then set the following: blend mode as overlay, color as white, opacity as 45%, click on this use global light option, and then set the angle as minus 90 degree. Set the distance as 0 pixels, choke as 0% and size to 15 pixels. After that, click on inner glow option and then set the following: blend mode as color burn, opacity as 45%, set the color as any gray color. After that, technique as softer, source as edge, choke to 0% and size to 50 pixels. After that, click on color overlay option and then set the blend mode as overlay, color as white, and reduce its opacity to 15%, and then click on OK. So as you can see, by adding this effect to the top layer is giving a realistic touch to the 3D over here. Let me just show you the overall effect. After that, we need to add background for this text. So for that, make the 3D depth group active by clicking on it and then click on create new fill or adjustment layer icon and then select gradient. After that, set the gradient as black and white and then click on OK. After that, set the style as radial, angle as 90 degree, scale it to 400%, and then click on this reverse option. After that, click on OK. Now bring this gradient layer at the bottom. So as you can see, we have added the background for the text over here. Now what if I tell you I don't like the color of the text and I want to change it to some different color? So now we will have to change the color for all the 75 layers which we have created. Sounds hectic, right? But you don't need to worry, because we have created the layers by duplicating the smart object layer. So all you need to do is open the original smart object layer over here and we just need to change the color of the text in the smart object document over here. So as you can see, we have a nice color for the text over here. Now all you need to do is save this smart object by pressing Ctrl plus S. And now go to the original document. And as you can see, the color has been applied to all of the 75 layers over here, and the 3D text looks somewhat like this. And I just wanted to tell you something for your information, that the depth of the 3D text will change according to the position of your text in that of the smart object document. Now let me just show you something what I'm talking about. So this is what I wanted to inform to you guys, that the depth of the text will be different according to the position of the text in that of the smart object document. So now as you can see, the 3D text is ready over here. Now I just want to give some touch ups to make it look more better. So for that, click on create new fill or adjustment layer icon and then select option gradient map. And then select the gradient as violet orange. And then click on OK. After that, minimize it. After that, change the blend mode of the layer to soft light and then reduce its opacity to 30%. After that, create a new layer by clicking on create new layer icon and then select brush tool. Brush as soft round and then set the foreground color as some golden color and then using brush tool hover as follows. After that, change the blend mode of the layer to soft light and reduce its opacity to 50%. So as you can see, our 3D text is looking somewhat like this. Now let's add some shadows to the background to make the 3D text look more realistic. So for that, make the 3D depth group active by clicking on it and then press Ctrl and click on the group above it to give you the selection of that group and keep the selection of the 3D depth group. After that, press Ctrl plus G to merge the two layers into a single group. After that, create a duplicate of this group by pressing Ctrl plus J and then hide the original group and then right click on the duplicate group layer and then select option merge group and then right click over there and then select option blending options. After that, click on the drop shadow option and then set the following: blend mode as multiply, color as black, opacity as 50%, untick the use global light option and then set the angle as 120 degree. Distance as 10 pixels, spread as 5% and size as 10 pixels and then click on OK. So that's it guys, this will give you your 3D text without using 3D in Photoshop. Now if you guys like this video, then hit the like button. Also share it to the ones who might be interested in such videos and subscribe to the channel for more videos in Photoshop. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.